I'm 38 now, and I feel like I'm probably in the best condition of my life through my diet, nutrition. Okay, so the rope crunches. I basically use these just to develop lower abs, because obviously they're the hardest ones to develop. I normally do 4 to 5 sets. As you can see, I've got it on 50 kilos at the moment. I normally keep that because you can use momentum to bring the weight down. The good thing about this exercise is the more weight you use, not excessive weight, but a good weight that you can balance as well when you pull down, will really help strengthen your core and really bring out those bottom abs, really get them to show. So it's all good core development. Obviously, if you do have good abdominals, it is a good sign of good core strength as well, but also, you know, it makes you feel good. You know, it gives you a complete package. Everybody, you know, wants a good set of abs, because it does just set off the physique just perfectly. So I think abs are one of them things that are noticed first, you know, beyond anything else. They need to be hit quite often. I mean, I train my abs probably twice a week, normally after two big body parts, normally 10 to 15 minutes, but I always do 5 sets of each exercise, but I only focus on the lower abdominal areas, as most people do have the top ones. But rope crunches will help develop middle to bottom ones, which are obviously the hardest ones most people struggle with. But again, a lot of it is also to do with genetics as well, because everyone does have different shaped abs. But you know, if you are struggling to try and get the bottom abs out, then it's that rope crunches will just help you get that thick in the midsection a bit and bring the abs out.
That's what you call a bear. So normally as well, you can do those, and you can actually do it until you feel a really good burn. It feels like a fire in your stomach when you do that. And normally just do as many as you can get on a really good weight, probably about 20 reps, something like that, but it's really good for, you can really feel the muscle burning straight afterwards.
Okay, so next thing I'm going to move on to are like dragon lifts. Again, good for lower abdominal work. It's good for core strength. Again, excellent for building up the bottom abs. Also does a lot of the hip flexor work. So it's really good for targeting obliques as well. But again, another great exercise for really strengthening the lower part of the abs and getting, just keeping it nice and flat at the bottom, and keeps the bottom contracted all the time. I love gym life. I just like the whole, you know, healthy lifestyle. I like feeling good about myself.
Okay, so here we go again.
It is tough. It took me a while to do initially, but again, if you've got a weak core, it's something that you don't really want to be starting off with. You should be just practicing on things like the rope crunches and stuff first, standard exercises, sit-ups, building up your core first. You can do it two ways. You can do it front as well, like the way I've just done. We can even do it from the side. You can actually bend from the sideways. So hit more oblique work if you want to do that kind of workout, depending on what you're aiming for. I think it's important that if you feel good about yourself, even when you are older, that you can, you know, inspire others who are younger as well, and that you can be in good shape at any time of your life. Definitely got better as I got older, yeah. Yeah, I think that's just for the fact that I think I've maintained my my physique for such a long time, and I feel it's got better over the years. I just think that my confidence has grown all the time.
Jason looked fantastic. He had a physique that was literally second to none.